everyone, this is Shayla with 3Fold News, and I'm here with Terrence Ross of the Phoenix Suns. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, I'm doing well.
So, congratulations to you. You've been in the league for 10 years, which is crazy. How much have you grown since that time? It's like you're like a kid to now like grown man from then. How do you feel about it?
No, it's been great. Definitely a journey. Never thought I'd be in this position, but you know, just taking it day by day. You know, just growing along the way. It's been a journey. I've been through a lot, but you know, I wouldn't trade it for anything.
Yeah, and I know years ago we asked you what was one of your first purchases as a rookie, and it was a Maserati. What made you go that high up in a purchase as a rookie?
Man, I think it was just being young, seeing all the other guys on my team, seeing what they were driving. So I need to get something that, you know, I feel like I can enjoy. And that car actually gave me a ton of trouble, so I kind of regret that purchase. But yeah, that was definitely one of my over-the-top purchases.
So from your rookie year to now, like, I would say who was the most challenging, like, person that you went up against your rookie year, and then who would it be now, if you can even think back that far?
Wow, it was a ton of people. It wasn't just one person. I would say I played right from Kevin to Kobe to LeBron, Carmelo. It was a challenge every night, especially being on the East when all those guys are out there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was no shortage of talent coming at me. So I'll probably say LeBron. He was tough. He ran the East for a really long time.
Yeah, it was the start of his like first years.
Yeah, his first 10 years going to the finals every year. So yeah, definitely I would say LeBron.
So how has the transition been for you and your family? Like, you're now here in Phoenix. You were with Orlando for so long, you know. How has that transition been for you guys?
It's not bad. My family's actually still out in Orlando. My kids are in school, so they're just finishing out the school year. But it's an easy transition for me. I'm pretty easygoing, so, you know, I don't live too far from the practice facility, so I have pretty much everything I need and a couple miles range. So it's been fun. I've been having a good time getting to know the guys and learning the coaches and just learning, you know, this new layout and this new this new atmosphere for me. So, but it's been fun.
How's it been for you just being here in Phoenix? Like, what's like your favorite part of Phoenix that you've discovered now?
Man, you know, it's crazy. Since I've been here, I haven't really had a lot of chances to do too much because we've been traveling and practicing and on the road a lot. So I definitely, you know, I'm enjoying Scottsdale, enjoying downtown Phoenix. That's probably where I spent the majority of my time. So, and I have a lot of friends, you know, from back home that randomly live out here. So
that's awesome.
I've been seeing a few people. So it's been cool just knowing that, you know, I have some familiar faces out here and they kind of show me around. So it's not too bad.
So lastly, what job do you think you'd have if you never made it to the league? Like, what do you think you'd be doing if you never played, if you didn't make it?
Honestly,
yeah,
I'd probably be a trainer. I would do something with basketball. Sure. That's always been my passion, something I'm good at. So I think, you know, if I could pass on knowledge to, you know, these younger kids and different generations, I feel like that would make me happy.
Do you think you'd ever want to be like a coach, like after, like you retire, be a Monty?
it's weird. Like, if I'd never played ball at this level, I think I probably would have transitioned into coaching.
Yeah.
So playing at this level, I don't know. I don't think I would. I don't think I would. Now I see how much, you know, time the coaches put in, how much they're here way before we are. They're, you know, at the gym way longer than we leave. So
yeah,
you know, they have a busy schedule. So seeing that side of it, I don't know. Makes it kind of play.
You're like, I'll assist on the side.
Yeah, I'll watch for distance, for sure.
All right, well, thank you so much. Killed in playoffs. We got you for a reason. No, I'm just kidding. This is Shayla with 3Fold News.